These were the panicked scenes as security forces arrived at the Bardo Museum. By that time, the gunman had already killed many people and moved deeper inside the complex.
That's terrified.
Wassel Bouzid witnessed the start of the massacre.
The moment when he started to shoot everybody in front of him, with no mercy, the blood and innocent people laying down.
Bouzid, a tourist guide, had been waiting by a bus for his tour group to return from the museum when he saw a man that didn't look like a terrorist.
Men.
In civilian clothes.
In civilian clothes.
Not military uniform.
Not military at all. Civilian. Blue jeans, Nike baskets, Nike shoes, blue jacket, and shaved. And he did not pronounce any word.
Bouzid says the man then pulled what looked like a gun, a Kalashnikov, from his bag, but didn't know how to use it.
Okay. At the moment, I thought he was one of the guests, one of the clients, one of the tourists, playing with a plastic gun.
He got it working just as crowds were leaving the museum.
Around 60 or 70 guests, and he started to shoot everybody in front of him.
Bouzid fled as security forces quickly arrived in bigger numbers. After killing the gunman, they were cheered as heroes. One of the attackers, Yassine-Labidi, lived here. His family is confused, grieving, and angry. His uncle, Abdel-Malik, says, it's true, Yassine carried out this terrorist attack. He was killed. We don't have his body back. Yassine was also a victim of terrorism. Phil Black, CNN, Tunis.